Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-31 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler. Statement is determine the displacement of point B on the A992 steel beam I is 80 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter power 4. So you can see this is a simply supported beam having a point load at point B, which is 20 kilonewtons. There is a pin support at point A and there is a roller support at point C. So due to this load, this beam will deflect like this. So you have to find this vertical displacement of point B. So let's start with the solution. So what will be the first step is that if you remove this pin support at point A, so you will be having a reaction force, vertical reaction force RAY, and there will be horizontal reaction force which will be equal to RAX. And similarly, if you remove this roller support, so there will be a reaction force, vertical reaction force, which will be RCY. So first we'll find this unknowns by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero, and force in this direction is taken as positive. So only there is one horizontal force acting in X direction, which is RAX. There is no other force, so it means that RAX is equal to zero. Now we'll use another equation that sum of all moments about point A is equal to zero and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So this is point A, so first moment will be due to 20 into perpendicular distance is 3, and this is producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 20 times 3. The second moment due to this RCY and perpendicular distance is 8, and this is producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. So I will write RCY into 8 is equal to 0. So from here we will get 8 RCY is equal to 60. So RCY will be equal to 60 divided by 8, and that will give you 7.5 kilonewton. Okay. We'll find this RAY by using third equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So RAY minus 20 plus 7.5 is equal to zero, and from here we will get RAY will be equal to 12.5 kilonewton. Now we have all these values. So what we will do is that we will go toward finding the moment equation. So what we will do is that we will cut the beam over here, and this will be the X. X is distance from point A till, and the region for X is greater or equal to 0 and less or equal to 3. And we will draw the free body diagram in order to find the equation of moment. So let this is the beam. This is your RA, which is equal to 12.5 kilonewton. This is distance X where you cut this beam. So when you cut this beam, you will be having a shear force that will be V, and you will be having a moment that will be equal to M. Let this is your point one. So we'll find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point one is equal to zero and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. Let we designate it as X1 because we will take another X2 as well. So this is X1. So sum of all moment about point one. So this will be the moment which will be equal to M. Clear? And this M will be equal to counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write plus M. The second moment is due to this 12 into perpendicular distance is X1, and this is clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 12.5, and there is a kilonewton. So I will convert it into newton. So 10 to the power 3 into X1 is equal to 0. So from here, M is equal to 12.5 into 10 to the power 3 times X1. And this equation of moment is valid for this region, X is greater than 0 and less or equal to 3. Now what we will do is that we will cut this beam at another location, and this location will be distance from x2, and x2 start from point C till point till distance of 5 meters. Clear? So for x2 is greater than or equal to 0 and less or equal to 5. And this was x1. Okay, now when you cut this beam, so again you have to draw the free body diagram. This is your point C where you have RCY, that is 7.5 vertically, 7.5 kilonewton, and this is the distance x2. So when you cut it, so you will be having a shear force, clear, V, and you will be having a moment in this direction. That is point 2. So what we will do is that we will find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point 2 is equal to 0, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point 2, one moment is minus M2, which is clockwise minus M, and the another moment is due to 7.5 into 10 to the power 3 into x2, which is counterclockwise. Their sum must be equal to 0. So moment will become equal to 7.5 into 10 to the power 3 x2. Clear? So this is the moment equation for the region x2 is greater than 0 and less or equal to 5. Now what we will do is that we will find that strain energy due to this moment, which is equal to UI, is equal to integral from 0 to L m square dx divided by 2EI. Since we have divided into two region for greater than 0 and less than 3, and for x is greater than 0 and less than 5, clear? So we will get this will be from 0 to 3 m square dx 1 divided by 2EI plus integral from 0 to 5, and that will be m square dx2 divided by 2EI. Now you can put the values over here, so you will get strain energy due to this bending will be from 0 to 3, m is 12.5 into 10 to the power 3 x1 divided by 2EI plus integral from 0 to 5 m is here, this will be the m, 7.5 for x2 into 10 to the power 3 x2, there will be a square because this is m square, and dx1 is there and dx2 is there, divided by 2EI. If you take 1 over 2 E common from both, so it will be 1 over 2 times EI multiply by, you will left with 0 to 3 12.5 into 10 to the power 3 multiply by x1 square dx1 plus integral from 0 to 5 into 7.5 into 10 to the power 3 x2 square dx2. Now, being an engineering student, you should be able to solve this integration. I will show you how to solve using calculator. So what we will do is that I will turn on the calculator and I will show you this equation in the calculator, how to write this equation. So first step is that you will take this integral and here you will put the bracket. First you will write 12.5 into 1000. Multiply by this x and you will close the bracket and there is a square and limit from 0 to 3 plus there is another integral which is this one 7.5 into 1000 multiply by again x whole square and limit will be from 0 to 5, and when you solve this you can see it is equal to, it will be equal to 3.75 into 10 to the power 9 divided by 2EI, and when you divide it by answer divide by 2 will give you 1.875 into 10 raised to power 9 divided by EI. That will be strain energy due to bending. This is how we use this calculator. So now we'll switch this and we will move toward, but again you should solve this by using integral, and if you feel any difficulty you can use the calculator. Clear? So this is the strain energy due to this movement. Now we know that due to this load, this beam will deflect like this. So this will be the delta B, vertical displacement or displacement of point B. And this displacement is equal to this, due to this load, the external work is done, which is stored in the form of strain energy, and that will be equal to 1/220 kN, 20 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by this delta B. So this is the external strain energy due to external load. Now I will write this strain energy due to external load will be 1/220 kN, so 20 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by delta B. So this is your equation number 1 and this is your equation number 2. So what we will do is that by using conservation of energy, this UE is equal to UI, so 1/2 multiplied by 20 into 10 raised to power 3 into delta B will be equal to 1.875 into 10 raised to power 9 divided by EI. So what we will get is delta B will be equal to 1.875 into 10 raised to power 9 multiplied by 2 divided by 20 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by I is given as 80 into 10 raised to power minus 6, that is in meter power 4. And what about E? So E for A992 steel. So we will go to the book A992 steel. You can see A992 steel E is 200 gigapascal. So note down this value as well, 200 into 10 raised to power 9. Now you have final value when you use calculator and you find this value, you will get it 0.0117 meter. Or in term of millimeter, this vertical displacement of point B will be equal to 11.7 millimeter. And this is the answer of our this question. And that was all about problem 14-31. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing my channel further. And if you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.